that's minimal, not for the Senate. For the House, yes. You'd have to go there because you've got a small, a very small constituency, and you have to pay attention to that constituency. But here we have a national constituency in the Senate, and there's no room for ground war. I mean, there's very little. I mean, you send out tarps and you send out leaflets, but you'll hardly cover the country.
Mm. In this case, you're running again for senator, but you're coming off an election loss in 2016. So what makes you think that somehow it would have a different result now?
Well, the one 2016 was not a loss, but so, I mean, I don't know how you guys look at it, but that was not a loss to me. But any case, you still have to get more enough votes to get into the winning column. And so I think I'm getting there.
But what was the big problem in 2016?
Cheating. The goddamn COMELEC cheated me. But anyway.
Smartmatic or COMELEC?
Smartmatic and COMELEC. Both of them. Because they had to do that to win it, to get the numbers correctly. And they cheated me.
But why you?
Why me? No. First, they did not cheat me itself. They cheated so that I went down. So I went down to number 11 from number 6. But that was because they sold 8 seats at 50 million each. Okay? So they sold us 8 seats and they added 6.5% to those 8 seats. Exactly 6.5%. That's why I spotted it right away, because of the last survey of May 3rd, 2016, and the elections were May 9th. It was exactly 6.5% they added to those 8 people. And those 8 people went up.
But again, why you? Why of all candidates?
No.
You were just...
No, I was just an innocent bystander then. Then the second round got me. The second round of cheating. Because they added 2.5% to Recto and 2.5% to Laila De Lima and deducted 2.5% from me. And that was also obvious.
But do you have an evidence for that?
No, I don't have any. I have evidence based on the final results, yes.
The patterns?
Yes.
But if that is your belief...
I have no evidence on how they did it, because it's all done by computer and... You know, unless Andy Bautista comes back here and testifies how the cheating was done. But he's not coming back.
So if you win a Senate seat again, you're going to conduct a hearing
you
and
bet.
Summon him?
You bet.
You're trying to get
But he's not here. Mm. Right now, he's in San Francisco already.
But then again, in the 2019 elections, you still have Smartmatic, you still have the same COMELEC.
Yes, you do.
So why run if you think that you were cheated?
Because I'm trying to get enough votes to get to a higher position so that if they cheat me again, I will not drop out of the Magic 12.
I have to get
about 6.5 points ahead of number 13 in this election.
How do you respond to those who usually dismiss claims like this as sour grapes? Basically, sore losers.
So what? Who cares? I mean, I know what I know, and then they don't know what they don't know. So it doesn't matter.
Now let's talk about the difference in terms of.
I'm not harping on it, but if people ask me, I said I was cheated. That's it.
Now let's talk about the difference in terms of, let's say, complexion of today's campaign, because you have so many familiar names. You're not just the old names in
yes.
that particular
yes.
campaign, pero. What are the bigger difficulties now? Because it's the slate is so stacked. So many want to run or to win seats, but you only have 12.
Well, you only have about 16 people in contention or 17 people in contention. So that makes it smaller.
Mm.
And you will see from that list, the 17 or 18 people in contention, the rest are really very low, 11%, etc. So... Below Francis Tolentino, you got 11% already. He's at 21%. So that's a big difference. And I'm trying to get 8 points, at land 6 points ahead of number 38. So I'll have to get to 44%. Now that's a big gap. I mean, that's a big jump, but I'll have to get there.
But in terms of...